Nathan MacKinnon, when you come from Cole Harbour, Nova Scotia, that's challenging. Kind of a large shadow cast by Sidney Crosby. He wins the Calder, but perhaps most impressively, what he did this season to go from 48 points the previous year to leading this team back into the playoffs, how'd he do it?
I think he figured it out, Tone, because we saw, because he was drafted first overall, we saw what he did his rookie season, how he had the potential to be a great offensive player, but he didn't really show it in the subsequent years after his rookie season, because we knew he could skate. And he can fly.
Oh, yeah.
His acceleration from zero to top speed is about as quick as anyone not named Connor McDavid. Mm. But where he has evolved this year is that he's learned how to apply that speed and how to use it to create better chances as opposed to running into trouble. Obviously, when he gets a little bit open ice, you're in trouble because he's going to create space and he's a powerful guy, so we can kind of work through checks, work through sticks and hands, and get around players. He added an element of finish to his game with this wrister because he doesn't hardly ever take slap shots. Talking to him, he jokes about his inability to actually shoot the puck that way. But when you're as fast as he is, he's able to push back defenders with his speed because when someone's coming at you that fast, you're scared. Mm-hmm. I don't want to get beat wide. I don't want to get beat in the net. So you back up to take advantage of that space. You have to learn how to shoot it on the fly. And that really was part of his game this past year that we had not seen previous years. The ability to take the puck off the rush and shoot it on the fly and beat goaltenders from 20, 30 feet. You look at what he did this year. Second in points per game. That's pretty incredible. Second team All-Star up there with the very best. And the massive 67 wow. home points, almost on pace for 140. If he could replicate on the road what he did at home, that home cooking, that thin air in Denver obviously suits his game just fine. And if you want to look like, how is he going to get better? That's where it is.
Sure.
Right? I mean, if you can get anywhere close to point per game, more than a point per game on the road, what he did at home, now you're talking 110, 115 points. That is very exclusive company these past few years. But really have to admire the strides he's taken because he was good. He was going to be an above-average player, but he wanted to push himself. And maybe there's something in the water in Cole Harbour. I don't know. I should go drink it because training with Sidney Crosby, being around him on the ice, off the ice, has helped Nathan MacKinnon. It's helped push him to be better, and he was much, much better this past year.
And we all watched that documentary, There's No Place Like Home, where we saw just how hard that work is alongside Crosby. Let's dive deeper into that excellence at home. Because if you're Jared Bednar, what a delight at Pepsi Center. You just throw them out. You know you're going to get points. How much of it has to do with thin air? How much is last change? And how much is just that this guy gallops?
It's all the above. I mean, really, I mean, to have that kind of season, almost 70 points at home, it's really pretty something. But they were a top-heavy line. That line with Rantanen and Landeskog was by far the dominant line on Colorado. So anytime you could get them in a preferred matchup, which would happen more often on the road, they could exploit it. When, you know, they're going up against the other team's top lines, against the Kopitars and Bergerons on the road, it's tougher. But when you get them out there against third and fourth lines, now you're on to something. And you're right. I played in Colorado. You get tired.
Yes.
You get 30 seconds in your shift. You can't feel your legs. You can't breathe. You got to drive. And you have these guys who are in great shape, used to playing at that altitude, and they could take advantage late in shifts at home. He's used to playing 20-something minutes, high-pace hockey with his line mates. All those things come together to make that home ice stat as impressive as it was this past year. You got to find a way to free yourself up on the road. And that'll be another challenge for the coach, for sure, for Nathan MacKinnon and his line mates. But home cooking was good for him this past season.